Welcome to Wired In. I'm Diana Galato with Hampton City Schools. Today I'm very pleased to be joined by Ms. Regina Proctor. Welcome.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
First off, Regina, you are the Hampton City Schools Teacher of the Year, so congratulations for that.
Thank you.
So we would like to know a little bit about your background. Tell us a little bit about where you grew up and a little bit about your background, your teaching background.
Okay, I'm actually a military child, so I was born in Delaware, but my parents have moved us to different states and countries over the years. I did come to Virginia in the eighth grade, attending Davis Middle School and then Bethel High School, graduating from there. I stayed in Virginia to attend Longwood University with a bachelor's in science and mathematics. After that, I began teaching for a few years, and being the lifelong learner I am, I wanted to go back and get more education, so I went to Troy University to earn a master's in education. So I've been teaching for 13 years now and continue to go back to school to earn a certification in math to teach college level courses.
So you are a Bethel Bruin at heart, graduated
sure
from Bethel, and you've taught Have you taught at Bethel your entire career?
The entire career at Bethel High School, yes ma'am.
So tell us, because I know there are several things special about Bethel High School, but what is unique or special to you about Bethel High School?
I will say, and it's not just Bethel High School, but Hampton City Schools, we have a lot of alumni that not only work in the school as educators, but also with our clubs and our extracurricular activities and our sports. So we have that hometown feel, and we just make people feel comfortable. I enjoy not only the people that I work with in the classroom, but my administrators, actually all of the administrators are Hampton City Schools alumni. So I just like how we make that feel like home when you come to Bethel High School, the home of academic excellence.
Yes. So tell me a little bit about exactly what you teach. You're a math teacher, but what specific math courses
do you teach? I teach geometry and statistics.
Okay.
So I have the 9th and 10th graders mainly in geometry, and then the 11th and 12th graders in statistics.
And it's no secret that a lot of people don't like math.
No, ma'am.
So tell me, what is it about math that you like so much that you're teaching it to our students?
It was one subject that came easily to me in school, and I didn't really find anything else in college that piqued my interest as much as math did. And I noticed a lot of times that not just young people, but people in general have a struggle with it. And I felt that I can make it easier for them to understand and to take it into the real world and use it in their everyday life.
So tell us a little bit about what specifically you like about teaching. What is your favorite thing about teaching?
I believe it's the fact that I can support the students. They may have any type of support at home, but I can be an extra support when they come to the school. I enjoy the fact that I have a rapport with my students. They love me to the fact that they invite me to their graduation parties, you know, their baby showers, or I just came from a pinning ceremony for a former student who's attending law school. Sadly to say, it's also been funerals as well, but it's just the fact that I am a support system to them, and I love being in the classroom with them.
So outside of teaching, because it sounds like teaching takes up a lot of your time.
Yes, ma'am.
But outside of teaching, what are you involved in? Do you have any hobbies or any particular interests?
I love traveling, doing new things, seeing new places. I enjoy staying fit by working out, Zumba. If I get a chance to, I love to read, theme parks, roller coasters.
Oh, wow. Is yes. there a favorite theme park?
No, I love them all. But I do enjoy spending time with family and friends. That's probably one thing that makes me the happiest.
So you talked a little bit about how you want to always continue learning.
Yes, ma'am.
So tell us a little bit about your aspirations. You said a little bit about teaching at the college level, but what may be next for you?
Well, the college level is because I like to prepare my students, for those who are planning to attend college, for the next level that happens in their life. Some come back and say they just didn't feel prepared, not necessarily for college, but living outside of high school where everything is set for them. But aspirations, not just teaching college, but traveling, continuing to travel. I love to go overseas more, and continuing my education, being able to teach more in different locations.
So where have you gone overseas that you really particularly enjoy?
We've lived in Germany and Japan, but I've been to the Caribbean. I just returned from Canada not too long ago. So I'll go just about anywhere. I love to just be in different places, different cultures, and I think that I gained that from being a military child, getting to know people of all places and all backgrounds and cultures.
So is there a specific place that you have a goal in terms of going to next?
Well, actually, I'm facilitating an educational tour to Italy next summer. Wow. Yes, ma'am, with some young people. And that was one of my premier locations to go to. So I get the opportunity with students to continue taking their learning from their history books and making it come alive to having a good time for myself.
So one of the things that I noticed lately with the Olympics being on is the fact that Bethel High School has two athletes that I know of competing in the Olympics, Francina McCory, who of course is a runner, and another student that I didn't know about until the last couple of days, Shakur Stevenson, who is a boxer and is competing in the boxing area. So what do you think about students like that who've gone to Bethel and go on and really positively represent Bethel and Hampton City Schools, not only on a national stage, but on a worldwide stage?
I am in awe, not just of those two, but any athlete or anyone who continues on and gets to make their dreams come true. And I am so grateful that not only myself, but all of these other educators have been a part of their life to help them attain those goals. And I think that that is really what we're here for, to be their support system and to show them that there is more to life than just, I shouldn't say it this way, but just school. You know, you can go and you can be anything that you like to be, especially an Olympic athlete.
So is there anything else that you'd like to share with us about you or about Bethel High School?
I just enjoy educating others. I enjoy my school. Mr. Saunders, the principal, was actually assistant principal at the time when I came out of college, and he will undoubtedly tell you that he was instrumental in getting me back to Bethel High School. He went as far as talking to my mother to ensure that I came back to Bethel to teach. So I am a Bruin at heart, bleed green and gold, and I just appreciate the opportunity that has been given to me by my students and my administration and to represent Hampton as the Teacher of the Year.
And I want to ask you one more thing about the Teacher of the Year. Last spring, when you were standing up on stage and everyone was watching, and you were named Hampton City School Teacher of the Year, what were the feelings and thoughts going through your mind at that time?
Complete nerves. Mm-hmm. I'm a very low-key, quiet person. In my classroom, I can come alive. So that was a bit much for me to be on stage and everybody's watching. But I felt wonderful and grateful to be acknowledged for what I do in the classroom for our students. It was really funny as Mr. Blau was repeating the words that I wrote. I said, those are my words, you know? So I tried to contain myself, and it just was those butterflies in your stomach where you're just like, oh my goodness, it was me, you're calling me. But it was a great feeling. Again, I'm just ever so grateful to everyone.
We're very proud of you. We know you're a great teacher, but it's also really neat that you grew up here and that you're teaching at the high school from which you graduated. That is just very exciting. So can I come visit your classroom
anytime,
next school year?
Anytime.
I would love to do that. And we would love for you to come back to Wired In and give us an update.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for watching Wired In. Have a great week. Thank you.